This is a Galaxy 979. Just cut through putting a 3-digit display in it. As you guys know, the switchboard and the display board, that's all made together. So what I wound up doing, I've got hot glue around it now to make sure that it doesn't move, but I'll cut a hole in the middle of that PC board where the old display was, so that the connector for the new display board would stick through the original PC board. And of course we left all of the LED digits disconnected, you know, the runs. We used a couple to help hold the PC board in place, and what I did was wedge the edge of the display so that it would fit through the 2-digit hole. You can see it's wedged just slightly. We've got some hot glue around it to help hold it in place, keep it from moving around in case it's in a truck or whatever. But it was pretty solid even without the hot glue. You can see the cable's plugged into the back of it there. And this one is getting an LC5200. It's for a friend of mine. And when it's finished, we'll cut some more video on.
Okay. Here we go. Got her installed. That looks pretty good. Radio covers radio covers 26815 to 28085. Okay, it's got the LesComm LC5200 in it. We have done the deluxe clarifier mod. Got all kind of slide in this puppy. Moves up to 21 and down to 08. So about 6 both ways. And the radio, one thing I can say about Galaxy radios, they come from the factory broadbanded. Receive is excellent from top to bottom. Of course, it's early in the morning, so there's not any traffic on right now. Later on today, when I get the radio all put back together, I'll get some video of it receiving signals, and also video of the transmitter, the output voltage readings and everything on the bird. But there is the LC5200. Apologize for the wires being in the way. That's what it looks like. Okay. And I don't have it mounted solid, don't have the wires all tied up, but I'll do that right here shortly. This is the first 979 to have an LC board in it. The LC5200 is a perfect match for this radio. It's not very large, doesn't take up much space, so it fits in there very nicely. Gives the radio all kind of capabilities. All right.
Okay, thanks, Mike. Here's the surprise. Notice that C there in front of the 38. This is a 3-digit display with a channel 1 reference. The first 979 I've done with a LesComm board, LesComm computerized board. did install the LC5200 in this one. LC5200, that little guy right there. You notice I, let's see if I can get it to focus here. Come on. See that standoff right there? I put that on there to stabilize the front of the board. There's not really any place to put a bracket there on the front. I wanted to make sure that the board stayed still. And yeah, there's the bracket there in the back. So I soldered a standoff in the opposite corner to make sure that this thing does good, you know, remains solid. All right. It goes from 26815 to 28085. Let's see here. Now, this board does have the capability for a band switch where it'll jump 45 channels at a time, but there's no place for the switches. Okay, there's negative 15, which is 26815. Alright, I'm going to roll over to 108, which is 28085. And you notice that once you get back down below 28, you see that little U right there? U99, uppers, channel 99. Now then, for your slide, it does have the LesComm Deluxe Clarifier. 28001 from 995 all the way down to there you go, that looks better. All the way down to 27989. I don't know what happened there. I'll have to look into that. Right there is center frequency. The clarifier is a little touchy, but I'm sure you can handle it. That's AM. Upper sideband, up, you might have to touch that one up. And lower sideband, got to touch that one up too. Actually, you know what? Upper sideband and AM are right on. Upper sideband, lower sideband, right on. I need to touch up AM. It's not too far off. SAM, upper side, lower side. Okay. If you move the clarifier off center, of course, the more you move it off center, the more differences there are between the modes. And probably what you should do is get you an LC347 counter if you don't have one already. Alright, let's see if we can't find some traffic here. Let's get on the international call frequency. There we go. I wonder why they do that. Alright, that's the international call frequency, upper side of 55. Let's go back down to the U.S. call frequency, lower side of 38. Now you're talking about some off-frequency radios. On channel 38, I hear them all the time. Really good receiver. Let me get the mic hooked up, and I'll show you on the bird what this thing is doing. Put the camera down for a second. Okay, switch to the dummy load. Got a hot receiver. You might even hear something with it sitting on the dummy load. Okay, move this light here so that it ain't interfering. AM, I'm sorry, lower sideband, channel 38, audio 1 2 3 4 5 5 4 3 2 1. That's about 22 watts right there, and I'm not yelling or hollering or anything else into the microphone. And I'm going to switch to AM. Dead key's about 4 watts and swings to about audio. Wow, about 23 watts. About 23 watts on AM. We're looking at the center scale. I've got a 50 watt bird slug in there. So we are watching the 50 watt scale, which is the one there in the middle. I'm on a stock hand mic. That's on AM. And again, this is sideband. Audio, 1, 2, audio. A good 22 watts on sideband. Now I'm going to slide all the way up to 99. There we go, 99. And we are still on sideband. Look at there, 22 watts. Like I said before, Galaxy, with all of their Galaxy Ranger made radios, including Galaxy with all their quality quirks, they've gotten better. All their radios come broadbanded. I mean, look at this. I'm on 995 SAM. We're dead keying 3 watts. This is on 995. And swinging to about 22, 23 watts. I'm going to go all the way around to the bottom. A little over 3 watts there, not quite 4. We're swinging to about 22. Okay, and put it on sideband. And here we go on sideband. We're running about 21, 22 watts on sideband. So, radio is very broadbanded. I'm getting ready to put the covers on it and box it up and send it to you. It's finally finished. Now, this board, I was going to tell you earlier, has scan-up capability, manual scan-up. It doesn't have the squelch scan. If you look at the video of the LC5304, this is basically an economy version of that board. And I put this one in here because of the size. It's smaller than the 5304. And, of course, the 979 is a little bit smaller radio. You still get 128 channels. But it has a scan-up, manual scan-up capability. And it does have band up, band down capability. As a matter of fact, it would go in that jack right there. But there's no place to mount the switch. All the switches in the front are, mounted on PC boards and stuff, and none of them are momentary. The only alternative would be to mount one in the back, which means drilling a hole in the radio and making it hard to get to. So it wouldn't do you much good. So I figured that 128 channels, you can spin the channel selector. Okay? Alright. If you got any questions, you know how to get a hold of me. Thanks.